Imagine being the first to do something. Now imagine being the first to do a multitude of somethings. This man didn't just imagine, he lived it for more than a decade. Born on Long Island, George Larry got his coaching career started at the high school level, then coached at college at Syracuse as well as Georgia Tech. He was a defensive line coach with the San Diego Chargers before becoming the head coach eventually at Georgia Tech, then was also a defensive line coach and defensive coordinator with the Minnesota Vikings. Named head football coach at UCF in 2004, O'Leary had a slow start to his tenure with the Knights. The following season, UCF jumped to Conference USA and posted the fourth best turnaround in NCAA history, hosted the first ever Conference USA championship, and played in their first ever bowl game, the Sheridan Hawaii Bowl. That year, he was named Conference USA Coach of the Year and the National Coach of the Year by SportsIllustrated.com. This was only the beginning to an impressive 12-year tenure with UCF. He later propelled the program to their first ever bowl win over Georgia in the Liberty Bowl, another Conference USA championship, two American Athletic Conference championships, and the Knights' first ever New Year's Six bowl victory. It was a game that positioned number 6 Baylor as the clear favorite in the 2013 Fiesta Bowl. O'Leary had his 12-1 team ready to play and shocked the nation with a 52-42 win, a number 10 ranking in the AP poll at the end of the year. Coach O'Leary did more for UCF than just winning the football field. He oversaw the modernization of the program by expanding the practice facilities, overseeing construction of the first indoor practice facility in Florida, the Nicholson Fieldhouse, and bringing an on-campus football stadium to UCF. His discipline went further than the field of play, as he made academics a pillar of the program. In his first semester here, the team improved their GPA to a 2.78, a record at UCF, and he continued trumping that the following year to a 2.8. The program went on to continuously reset APR records throughout his tenure. O'Leary's success were plentiful, and his hard-nosed old-school mentality helped shape boys into young men whose family and this program can be proud of. In 2017, a statue was erected in his honor.